Here we're asked to graph a quadratic function. We know quadratic functions graph to be parabolas. Let's first find the y-intercept. The y-intercept occurs when x is 0. So when x is 0 in this case, y is going to be negative 9. Next, let's find the x-intercepts. Now the x-intercepts are always going to occur when y is equal to 0. So in this particular case, we have 0 equals negative x squared plus 6x minus 9. Now what we have here is a quadratic equation in standard form, but the leading coefficient is negative. So what I'm going to do is multiply everything by negative 1 and get the equivalent equation, x squared minus 6x plus 9 equals 0. I did that because it's going to be much easier to factor when the leading coefficient is positive. Okay, so x times x is x squared. 9 factors into 3 times 3. Adds up to negative 6 if they're both negative. And then a negative 3 times a negative 3 is positive 9. So it's factored correctly, then we set each factor equal to 0. Okay, notice here the two solutions that we get, they're the same solution, so that's called a double root. In fact, we only get one x-intercept. So the x-intercept here is 3, comma 0. Okay, so the next step is to find the vertex. We have a handy formula to find the x value of the vertex, negative b over 2a. In this particular case, a is negative 1, b is 6, and c is negative 9. So when we plug in the numbers here, we get negative 6, that's negative b, all over 2 times a, and a happens to be negative 1. Okay, so negative 6 over negative 2 is 3. Positive 3. Now to find the corresponding y value, take that 3 and plug it in. When you make that substitution, be careful with that leading negative. We're substituting 3 in for x, so the base here is just 3. 3 squared is 9, leave the negative there, so negative 9 plus 18 minus 9, well that's going to add up to be 0. So the vertex is the same as the x-intercept, and that's going to occur here at 3 comma 0. Okay, so we have the y-intercept, we have the x-intercept, there's only one, and we have the vertex. In fact, though, we only have 2 points, and certainly 2 points are not enough to graph a parabola. So we're going to have to make a chart of values and choose a couple other points to see what this picture is going to look like. Okay, we know the vertex occurs at 3, 0. So let's see what happens on either side of that vertex. Let's see what happens when x is 2 and also when x is 4. Okay, when x is 2, I'll take that and substitute that in. Negative 2 squared plus 6 times 2 minus the 9. Okay, so negative 4 plus 12 minus 9. Well, that adds up to negative 1. Okay, so 2 comma negative 1 is a point on the graph. Now let's see what happens when I substitute in the 4. Squared plus 6 times 4 minus 9. Negative 16 plus 24 minus 9. Well, that equals negative 1 as well. Okay, so now I think we're ready to graph this. We have the y-intercept, we have the x-intercept in the vertex, and a couple other points. So let me draw in a Cartesian coordinate system. Okay, so now let's put some dots. So 0 comma negative 9. 3 comma 0 is my x-intercept and vertex. 2 comma negative 1, sorry about the small scale. And 4 comma negative 1. So here's a few points. We know the parabola opens down because the leading coefficient is negative. So the basic picture, the rough sketch is going to look like that. Let me connect the dots. Okay, here's a rough sketch connecting the dots. Notice here if I draw a vertical line through the vertex, that's my line of symmetry at x equals 3. So we can get a point of symmetry that corresponds to this 0 comma negative 9 out here. Here it looks like we have 3 units, so if we add another 3 units, this point should be 6, comma, negative 9. So you could see my graph's not so great. But yeah, so there it is. That's a rough sketch of the original quadratic function.